Hello, this is Eric. Here you will see a very familiar screen. This ESP32 is connected to the camera and the camera is looking at the clock. In my hand, the image obtained via Wi-Fi from ESP32 is being viewed through my phone's web browser. Actually, this is totally different from connecting an OV2640 to ESP32. If you look closely, the general USB web camera is connected to ESP32. Also, the board is ESP32-S2, not ESP32. And if you look at the title of the web browser displayed on my phone, it says ESP32-S2 UVC demo. As you know, ESP32-S2 supports a native USB interface. It works as a USB host and allows data communication by connecting USB peripherals. Unfortunately, it's an old version of the USB interface, which is 1.1, and the maximum speed of this USB is 12 megabit per second, so you cannot expect that fast. In one of my ESP32-S2 projects, I compared the serial and USB communication speed with this S2. Please check it out if you are interested. My current camera resolution is 320x240, and I was able to get a frame rate of approximately 15 fps. Officially, it should output about 33 fps at 320x240 resolution, but with my camera, I couldn't reduce the interval between images to the maximum. This seems to be possible only if the USB camera supports it. Here is today's hardware. The USB camera I tested is a very old model, supports USB 2.0 and 480 megabit per second. I think you can probably find the kind of old model of USB camera if you look through your garage. This is a T8 ESP32-S2 made by Religo. I bought this because I prefer products with displays. It has a display ST7789. A project using this can also be found in the video description below. USB data plus is connected to GPIO 20 and data minus is connected to GPIO 19. The remaining pins are ground and VBUS. As you can see, the USB breakout I have is a micro USB. However, since the USB camera is a USB type A, another adapter was used to connect it. Next time, I will all change to USB type C. Anyway, I connected it to the camera and the USB interface of the S2. This completes the hardware preparation. Easy, right? Now let's prepare the software to test. This is an example of USB camera Wi-Fi transfer of ESP IoT solution that I will use for today's demo. There are a few things you need to know first to try this out. You must have an S2 or S3 with at least 2 MB of PSRAM, and your USB camera must support MJPEG compression. It should be possible to set the packet size not to exceed the maximum of 5 terabytes. The image transmission bandwidth must be less than 4 Mbps. It says due to USB asynchronous transfer bandwidth limitations, the image frame rate and single image size are mutually limited. If the image size is 25 kilobytes per frame, the frame rate cannot exceed 20 fps. Also, IDF environment is required to build this. I'm assuming you are already ready for this. In order to save your time, I will bring the code quickly and explain only the necessary parts. The code is pulled from this branch through GitHub. Please note that there is no UVC stream in the IoT solution main branch yet. After you get them, go to ESP IoT solution, example USB host, USB camera Wi-Fi transfer. Open VS Code and select the serial port connected to the device. Also, you need to set the target to S2 or S3 you have. Then you can see the SK config file has been created. I will update only the necessary parts here. If you look at the bottom of the menu on the left, you will find the menu called UVC stream. To see the full configuration descriptor of the connected USB, you need to increase this max control transfer data size. In my case, 5 terabytes was possible, but if the full descriptor does not come out, you can increase this size. This example supports both Wi-Fi station mode and AP mode. I will set it to the station mode and automatically connect to my local network. All looks good, save and go to the main code. Now what we need to do is modify the UVC config part to match the USB camera to be connected. This is the most annoying part. As shown on the screen, each field looks like nothing special. If this is updated for your camera, the image can be acquired via UVC. Information for UVC connection can be obtained through the interface descriptor of the connected camera. The problem is that some information is missing and some are even wrong. First of all, let's build and flash to the device without touching anything. something goes by quickly. Also, errors occur in the UVC stream. Of course, nothing easy. Restart the terminal and look at the log. Wi-Fi is connected normally and the assigned IP address is printed. If you open this in your browser, you can access the stream page of ESP32-S2. The image isn't visible because something goes wrong. We need to fix it. Here is the interface descriptor we need. Using this information, we need to complete our UVC config. Let me copy this information into my text editor. This is information about the USB camera I have. Each manufacturer and device has different information. You can see that there are multiple interface descriptors. Among these many interfaces, you find the MJPEG descriptor. If not, your camera may not support MJPEG compression. Now let's edit the UVC config. The predefined information wasn't working for my device, so let me take each field first. It makes me easy to change the field. I will try to update it with the information I have here. Usually there is only one configuration descriptor, so this is usually one. The MJPEG format index will be the number of the interface with the MJPEG descriptor. It's one in my case. The image width and height are in MJPEG format. The buffer size must be greater than or equal to the image size. If you run into problems with the buffer size, try increasing it. Frame index indicates the resolution of the image. Originally, VS MJPEG frame descriptor has B frame index for each resolution, but my descriptor doesn't have this information, so I set it to 1 first. I have no idea because it doesn't show any information about each resolution. Set the FPS by adjusting the interval between frames. For my camera, 0.05 seconds or 0.066 seconds is the fastest setting. Let me set it to 0.066 seconds. The rest are the interface index, endpoint address, and the MPS, maximum packet size of the endpoint, and the interface alternative number. Let's try again with this condition. There is an error with the UVC stream again. Currently, my problem is that the frame index does not match. Unfortunately, my JPEG descriptor doesn't show the frame index for each resolution. So I had to find them one by one, increasing the number. Let me put number 4 in frame index and build it again. This time, there are no problems. Nice. Let's check the video coming through the web browser. The image is finally visible. If the frame index is 4, the resolution of the image is 320 by 240 in my case. If I could set the frame interval to 0.033 seconds, I would have got a faster frame rate. Anyway, this is the best for now. As I did, you will have to find the right settings for your USB camera yourself. I tried to find a resolution of 640 by 480 but failed. I don't know why. Instead, I was able to get an image with a resolution above that, 800 by 600. At 800 by 600 resolution, I was able to get a frame rate of approximately 5 FPS. The good thing about using a USB camera is that it saves lots of GPIO. Let's say you are using ESP32-AI Thinkabout. Many GPIOs are sacrificed to connect to the OVTX40 and running out of available GPIOs. However, it has still the disadvantage of being slow. It would be really nice if it was at least an interface of USB 2.0 though. If you must use a USB camera with ESP32-S2 or S3, please give it a try. Maybe you can find a better way to use it. Who knows? Okay, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. See you on the next project.